मद्गुण सुति मात्रेन मयि सर्वो गुहासये मनोगतिरविच्छिन्ना यथा गंगाम्बसो अम्बदु लक्षणं भक्ति योगस्य निर्गुणस्य हि उदाहृतम् अहेतुकी अव्यवहिता या भक्तिः पुरुषोत्तमे मद्गुण सूति मात्रेण मयि सर्वो गुहासये मनोगतिरविच्छिन्ना यथा गंगाम्बस अम्बधौ लक्षणं भक्ति योगस्य निर्गुणस्य हि उदाहृतम् अहेतुकी अप्रतिहता या भक्ति पुरुषोत्तमे गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड दैट मेटेरियल पीपल कैन गो ऑन स्पीकिंग मेटेरियल थिंग्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू बी केयरफुल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड that material people can go on speaking all material topics in front of you. You cannot stop them, but try to remain indifference. Try to keep yourself aloof, indifferent. And if you are targeted, fix up. Shuddha bhakti, pure bhakti, one-pointed devotion. If your target is fix up, then no amount of trouble can stand in the way of your bhajan. Be careful. If your target is fixed up, then no amount of trouble, problem can stand in the way of your bhajan. That is the secrecy of your bhajan. The sloka I started with is very important sloka you can remember. Spoken by Kapilji Maharaj in front of Mada Devahati. That Madguna Suti Matreno Mai Sarva Guhasaye. Mai Sarva Guhasaye, secrets of the secrets. You can remember some days before I was speaking about Jamraj Maharaj speaking to his servants. Guiham Vishuddhyam Durvadhyam Yadgatya Amritam Asnute. To get Amrita, if you are really interested to get Amrita, nectar, you will have to give something, you have to suffer at present. I know it's very typical thing, but still you will have to do it. Otherwise, you can lose your life. You cannot come out successful. You should take resolution that I cannot miss this life. Topmost opportunity I am getting in this life, I cannot miss this life. If I miss what will happen next life, I cannot put any guarantee. There is no guarantee. So actually, Mai Sarva Guhasaye mean Bhagavan Kapilji Maharaj speaking to Mother, secrets of the all secrets, me, you know, Madhuguna Suti Matrena Mai Sarva Guhasaye, after hearing my all glories, nectarian katha, then when your mind going to flow like Ganga, from Himalaya and coming down and down and down, nobody can stop. Madguna suti matrena mai sarvo guhasai manogati ravi chenna yatha ganga ambaso ambadho. Yatha ganga ambaso ambadho. Like Ganga water, Ganga, running towards ocean, sea. Who can stop? That's why Kapilji Maharaj speaking, to give us a clear idea about what is actually Dhruvanusriti. Dhruvanusriti is non-stop thinking of Supreme Lord, without which our Rairamananda Sangha discussion is incomplete. You should grow this kind of mentality. Dhruvanusriti means there is no gapping inside your mind. There is no gapping inside your hands when you are going to, you know, get some Maya topics. There is no gapping. Maharaj, excuse me, I was in Maya. I never wanted to disobey. Foolish. Dhruvanusruti means it's so strong thing. Dhruvanusruti means, Dhruva means fixed up. Like the star Dhubatara, you know, that star there is fixed up. Like that, fix up your mind is steady, fix up your target is fixed up, and your mind running towards it. There is no gapping. There is no gapping. So, Dhruvanusriti actually means in Sanskrit, Amrito dharavad avichinnam tat dhubanusritihi. Amrito dhara, a nectarian flow, you cannot explain. You cannot explain, it is inexplicable. You cannot explain why your heart is so blissful. You cannot say. The reason exact. Amrita, it's nectar. No dissatisfaction, no burning, nothing. Amrita dharavat avichinnam, non-stop flow of bhakti going to give you constant memory. Avisriti Krishna Padaravinda your Khinoti Avadrani Chasang Tanoti Chatasasuddhim Paramatma Bhaktim Gyananca Vijnana Virago Yuktam. You can remember. Kopiji Maharaj is going to give this excellent example in front of Mata Devahuti that this is called actually bhakti. Nirguna bhakti. Nirguna bhakti. Bhakti yogasya nirgunasya. Hi udahitam. The example I given, my mother, the example I give to you is an example, lakshanam bhakti yogasya. Lakshanam bhakti yogasya nirgunasya. Bhakti yoga is an open term. If Kapilji Maharaj is going to stop up to this point, lakshanam bhakti yogasya, then it is not clear. But Kapilji Maharaj is going to speak clearly, lakshanam bhakti yogasya nirgunasya. Follow. Viseshasya jallingam vibhakti vachane cha ja tani sarvani jajyani visheshan padevapi. Visheshya visheshan. You know, subject predicate. You have to be careful. In Sanskrit you have to give what vibhakti, case ending you have to put this same thing. Follow. Lakshanam bhakti yogasya nirgunasya udahitam. I give you this example and which is causeless bhakti. Nirgunasya udahitam, nirguna bhakti. Why you are doing bhakti? To get bhakti more? There's no reason. Ahituki apratihata, ba abhyabhavita. Ahituki apratihata, ya bhakti hi purushottame. Leela purushottam. Purushottam bratho. Ahituki apratihata ya bhakti hi purushottam. That bhakti is running towards purushottam. Purushottam. Govardhana dharam bandi gopal gopo rupinam gokula mahatsava ishanam govinda gopika priyam is purushottam. This is called, you should remember. Also you can remember, sometime before I discussed that you should grow this kind of bhava. What is that in Bhagavatam, first canto, second chapter, it is written, Srinnatam sa kataha krishnaha punna sravana kirtanaha hriddantastahi avadrani vidhunoti suhit satam. Try to give your attention. Same thing which Kapilji Maharaj speaking, but more specifically here, we can get some clear idea. The Srinnatam Sva Kataha Krishnaha. when you can go on hearing aprakita harikatha, nectarian harikatha from the lotus mouth of a pure devotee, powerful devotee, who can install bhakti inside your heart, that type of, then, because punya sravana kirtanaha is a topmost excellent punya sravana kirtanaha, in that case, riddhantosto hi abhadrani. If there is abhadra, anartha, abhadra mean anartha. Abhadra mean actually anartha. Abhadrani actually Prabhupada wanted to make meaning, you know, ragadi vasanaha tani. Ragadi vasanaha tani sarvani. Follow what I say. You know, avadrani mean anartha. So this anartha can go away gradually. Gradually you can, you can clean or anartha, you can very clean, we can very easily clean anartha which is already there inside your heart. Sinnatam sa kataha krishnaha punna sravano kirtanaha riddhantastahi avadrani vidunoti suhit satam. Yatha yatha atma parimajyate asau matpunna gatha savano vidhanai tatha tatha pashvati vastu suksham chakshu saiva anjana samprajuktam. You can remember, long ago, maybe 1 year before, I can remember, I discussed this sloka. Yatha yatha atma parimajyate acho. As you are going to clean your heart more and more, yatha yatha atma parimijjita so matpunna gatha savano vidhani. Matpunna gatha mane mai harikatha nicharyan harikatha. You are hearing more and more. The more you hear, the more you can clean your heart. And tatha tatha, accordingly, you can grow the habit, you can grow the habit to see very, very fine thing, tattva vigyan. Now your darshan is gross darshan. You can see woman, man, you know, handsome man, beautiful lady, stool, urine, this you can see. But when your darshan power become very fine, then you can learn to see all fine things. Anything you are looking, but behind that, always remember, anything you are looking, behind that, one sukshma darshan, fine darshan is there, which is only possible for pure Guru Vishnu, not for general people. So-called devotees cannot have that kind of darshan, fine darshan. That is why yatha yatha atma parimijjita so matpunna gatha savano vidhanai tatha tatha, accordingly, that jivatma can go on developing his fine darshan, tattva darshan. Just like when my mother used to apply black in my eyes in childhood. Why? Because if mother wanted to apply black, you know, because in that case I can develop fine darshan. Fine darshan, my material fine darshan. But this fine darshan is accurately fine darshan, tattva darshan. Whenever you look anywhere, anything, don't try to apply your business mood. Then you cannot get respite. Topmost danger is business mood. Business mood is very dangerous. That's why before leaving body, Prabhupada speaking, I am just fed up to change the mentality of these two devotees. Still today cannot change their business mood, Prabhupada speaking. Still today I cannot make their, one is Jagat Bandhu Vik Bhakti Ranjan. He gave so many things to Prabhupada. You know, Prabhupada was you know, speaking this way. And one is who make Jokpitsi Mandir is there, actually, Sakhicharan Baba. Baba speaking, these two, I tried my best, but still today, you know, they are not going to clean their heart totally. Anyway, they are our Guru Varga. We are discussing to get perfection ourselves, not to criticize them. Later on, they develop that kind of bhakti by the mercy of Prabhupada, because Prabhupada is responsible, so who can stop them? Anyway, this is an example. Prabhupada says, still today, I cannot change their business mentality. What is this? That's why Prabhupada used to give them one nice title. You cannot understand in English, it is in Sanskrit. Sestario, Setiario. It is mean in Sandhi Vichet, if you make it split up according to Sanskrit grammar, Seti Ajario, Seti Ario, Arjo means Sesto, Seti means businessman. Seti means businessman, Sedji, Seti, and second part is, you know, Arjuna Sesto, topmost businessman. Setyaryu, Setyaryu, Prabhupada used to speak. Anyway, so you see, try to understand, Sinnatam Sakataha Kataha Krishnaha Punna Sravana Kirtanaha, all beautiful Harikatha, Nectarian Harikatha, you can Punna Sravana Kirtanaha, Hridantastho hi abhadrani vidunoti svihit satam. Surely, if you are going to hear from heart, surely all anartha can go away very easily. If you are not going to hear from heart, then what guarantee I can give? You have to hear from heart, then I can give in the name of Prabhupada and Guru Maharaj. But you are not going to give me guarantee, so I can also. Cannot be, you are not going to change your mood. Actually, now your body is my body. Try to understand. Your body is now my body, not your body, so that you can run accordingly. I can use your body, your mind, everything for the cause of Krishna Seva. That is called actually bhakti. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told same thing to Sanatan. Sanatan, is his body is my body. I can use it for Krishna Seva. Who are you to, you know, suicide? You have your power? Now you already give me this body submission through submission. So your body is now my body. Don't try to play any trick. Then I cannot save you. If you are going to hell, then I am bound to go to hell to protect you. If you are going to hell, surely. If you are going to hell, then you can find me. I am going to reach hell and speak. What you are doing here? Why not you come and hear Harikatha? Sure. This is our actual internal relationship between you and me. Loveful relationship. Outside people cannot discover it. Impossible. So try to understand this point. Nasto prayeshu avhadreshu nityam bhagavata sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Sloke Bhaktir Bhavati Nashtiki. Kapilji Maharaj going to speak the definition of Nirguna Bhakti, Ayatuke Bhakti. Now I going to scientifically explain by the help of Bhagavad Mahapuran. Then we can have free access into Rairavananda Sangat. Very clear. Very clean. Nashto prayasu avadreshu nityam Bhagavat. Bhagavata Sevaya, try to understand. Nasto prayasu avadreshu nityam Bhagavata Sevaya, Bhagavati Uttama Sloke, Vaktir Bhavati Nashtiki. Nashtiki means yesterday I was discussing. Why I was discussing, you can remember. Nishtha, Nashtiki, rigid, very solid foundation of bhakti you are going to get. So you should understand. Nasto prayasu avadreshu. This sloka, you can remember yesterday, I was speaking half sloka, I couldn't remember. Now I remember. Actually, I wanted to apply this sloka under the guidance of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Kesava Goswami Maharaj. They are also speaking same. This nostro price avadreshu, avadra mean, you know, avadra mean anartha. Very clean. By now, it is very clean to you. When a so-called devotee is trying his best to do Bhagavad Seva means both Bhagavad. One is Grantha Bhagavad, another is Bhakta Bhagavad, both. So, nastro prayasu avadreshu nityam Bhagavata Sevaya. Bhagavata Sevaya, in one term it is written, but you can get double meaning. One is Bhakta Bhagavat and is Guntha Bhagavat. Because Bhakta Bhagavat, because you cannot have any clear conception about Bhagavatam. Only and only you can know Bhagavatam by the help of another Bhagavatam. That another Bhagavatam is Bhakta Bhagavatam. Bhakta Bhagavatam can open the mystery of Bhagavatam in front of you. Say, actually, Bhakta Bhagavat, Guntha Bhagavat, non-difference. But still, Bhakta Bhagavat appear in front of me to explain clearly what is written in Bhagavatam. Because Bhagavat is Krishna himself. That is why, actually, Tattvato, as per Siddhanta Vichara, they are all the same. So, one an identical tattva, but still having two different forms. One is Bhakta Bhagavat, another is Grantha Bhagavat, book Bhagavat. So, nostro prayasu avadreshu, it means when you are going to serve Bhakta Bhagavat, Grantha Bhagavat, then almost your anartha gone. Almost. A smell of anartha or some marking is there. Like I give you example yesterday, you can use kashai. Kashai mean, suppose you somebody going to chew bitter leaf and is going to spit on one place. You want to clean that place? Almost clean, but still there is stain. There is stain spot is there. So this way you should understand that nastro prayasu avadreshu nityam bhagavata sevaya, then Bhagavati Uttama Sloke, Bhagavati, Athat in Bhagavan, who is Uttam Slok, Atha Supreme Lord, you can get Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki. Then you can get Naishtiki Bhakti, one-pointed devotion. Very nice Bhakti you can get. Now I wanted to apply this slok for this Rasa Leela last slok. Though the topic is not this, but still I can touch it. But when our topics can come to give us facility to discuss this point, then I can discuss in details. Now I am going to touch this point. Vikriritam bhajavad viridancha vishnu sraddhanitam manasrinumad atavarnayajya bhaktim param bhagavatim pratilobhyakamam hridrogamasupahinat achirena, you know, dhiraha. This sloka, if you explain, then when we are full of anartha, we can go on hearing Rasa Leela. Who told? It is prohibited. Foolish number one. You are going against Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, everything, Kesava Goswami. You are foolish. Clearly, I can point out from the books of Shikshamita, Jayabhadrama Goswami, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. When there is mixed population, mixed devotees, then you should do Dasara, Sekreta, you can do Vasala, maximum, not Madhurasa, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. When there is some pure devotee, like-minded me, when they have same bhava, almost, then you can, like the example is just fitting here. If you can think about Sriman Mahaprabhu giving the example, any example given by Mahaprabhu is the topmost example. Who can beat? Who can, you know? Because Supreme Lord is never going to be defeated by anybody. Only by Prema Bhakta, Bhagavan, Aham Bhakta Praha Paradhino, He Ashatantra Ivadiyo. I am guided by devotee. I am sold to devotees, pure devotees, yes. That is why, you know, it is written That Mahaprabhu giving this example, so it is this example. When Mahaprabhu going to lead family life, it is also an example for us. Topmost example. When Mahaprabhu going to lead family life, if you can go through Chaitanya Bhagavat, you can find his topmost example. When Mahaprabhu going to read, you know, books and everything as a student, is topmost. When Mahaprabhu going to play the part of a teacher, is topmost. Everything topmost. Yes, Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, who can? Who is going to, you know? So you see, the Supreme Lord actually going to give the example that how to get the taste of Madhurasa, Parakya Rasa. Mapo giving the example. So Rai Ramananda Sangbad, you are discussing. Ultimately, you can find what Rai Ramananda Mahaswai wanted to speak by the desire of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. That same thing, Mahaprabhu going to relish, enjoy. Inside Gambira Mandir, exclusively, Raya Mahasaya, Sarvadamada, Raya Ramananda, and Gauranga Mahaprabhu. No third person there. Govinda is there, but Govinda is less interested about it. Govinda is the only understand how to arrange prasadam to Prabhu, seva of Prabhu. When Rai Ramananda Sarvadamada, everybody laughing, then Govinda, if get information, he is also laughing. Why laughing? You don't know. Govinda is only interested about how to serve Prabhu perfectly. I can discuss next topics our Nilachale Mahaprabhu. Nilachale Mahaprabhu. There Nilachalda Mahaprabhu is. So you see, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking same. And also you can remember when Gauranga Mahaprabhu going to do Sankirtan Ras. That Ras is, you know, non-different from that Ras. You know, same. But you cannot understand. You know, in Vrindavan that Ras, Mahaprabhu going to do this Ras inside the house of Sivas Pandit. But you can remember, the door is closed. Outsiders are not allowed to get entry. Trespassers will be prosecuted. Nobody allowed. The grandmother, mother-in-law of Sivas Pandit wanted to get entry, but she was expelled by Sivas. Go outside. Even Suklambar Brahmachari was going through so much austerity and penances there in his life. But still Mahaprabhu was not going to allow him to get entry into Rasalila. On the contrary, Mahaprabhu was very angry. What do you think? What do you think? You think you are doing Australian finances? You are drinking milk and this, that? You can see me? You can know me? Are actually demons, they are also doing, you know, tapasya. Those demons. Those demons, they are also doing tapasya. Na bhutam na bhavishyati. So what? Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyaksha, you know, Ravan, they are all doing tapasya. Hiranyakashipu doing tapasya. Brahma speaking, na bhutam na bhavishyati. No demigods, no rishimani, nobody can do this kind of tapasya. Oh my God. Na bhutam na bhavishyati. In future, not in past, not present and not in future. Present you are doing. So still, he cannot get bhakti. There is no guarantee that he can get bhakti. So don't try to be busy with the Australian finances. Only try to concentrate on seva. Non-irvinno, Prabhupada very often used to speak this sloka. Non-irvinno, nati shakta, bhakti yoga asya siddhita. Who is not feeling too much attachment, everything, looking everything in relation to Krishna, Prabhu. Oh no, detachment is not so strong. Oh, okay, it's there, it's a topics of Krishna Seva, an object of Krishna Seva. What is concerned to me? Who are you to do so detachment or attachment? That is I can discuss tomorrow if time permits. So, nasto prayasu abhadresu nityam bhagavata sevaya bhagavati uttama sloke Bhagavati, I mean Supreme Lord, Uttam Slok, and Bhaktir Bhavati Nashtiki. It is guaranteed. You can get Nashtiki Bhakti. So this Nashto Prayas Avadrishu, you know, Kesava Goswami Maharaj also giving same, Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they are all. Those are almost going to clean their heart. There's some there, some spot, you know, marking. For them it is written. Not that pool of anartha, pool of, go on reading Rasa Leela, you can get. Idiot, foolish. It's total misguidance. No, nothing written there. If it is written there, a Bhagavad Sat, this sloka is itself evidence. This I can speak also the next sloka, which is 100% evidence in favor of my judgment. I mean Siddhanta Vichar. First, is this sloka, Nashto Prayasu Avadresu Nittam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Sloke Bhaktir Bhavati Nashtiki. This sloka I explain. And just next sloka, going to speak clearly, when your Nashtiki Bhakti, Nishtha, rigidity, that kind of Bhakti going to appear inside your heart, then no question of Rajatama Bhava to stay inside your heart. No trace of Rajatama. Who can say? It's guaranteed. Tada, because the next sloka is guaranteed. Tada, Rajastama Bhavaha Kamo Lobhadayaschaje Cheto Etoir Anabhidyam Cheto Etoir Anabhidyam Stittam satte prasidati. Try to understand scientific evidence. Tada means previous sloka explained. Tada, in that case, Rajastama Bhavaha, divine can Rajatama Bhava already there, in the form of anartha, contamination, and also kamo lova, divine can desire, and lova, greed, you know, already there inside the heart. But tada, in that case, previous condition, I already wrote. Tada, in that case, Rajastama Bhavaha kamo lova dayaschaje. Kama lova dayaschaje means adi, etc. Try to understand. Kamo lova dayaschaje. If you split up, this meaning, if somebody knowing Sanskrit, they can understand. Tada, in that case, Rajastama Bhavaha, if at all any contamination there, and for the presence of kamo loka rajatamo satoguna as a there contamination, so naturally you are going to feel kamo lobha dayaschaje, kamo lobho adayo mane etc. So tada rajastama bhavaha ar kamo lobha dayaschaje, kam krodh lobho moho mado maschajyo, everything all covering different kind of artha. Follow what I say. In that case, none of them can stay inside heart. Because heart is clean. Cheto etoir anavidyam. Cheto etoir anavidyam. Etoir, you know, cheto, your heart is not going to be contaminated by any touch. Any such touch. No touch of such contamination. Tada rajastama bhavaha kamo lobhadayaschaje cheto etoir anavidyam. Now, no smell of contamination can stand. And then what will happen? Balamanaj Maharaj, in that case, sthitam cha satte prasidati. All your heart become full satta, pure satta. Stityam satya prasidati. Stityam satya prasidati means satogun is not there inside your heart. Maharaj, satogun is already there inside your heart. I am not speaking about that satya, contaminated satya. Your inside your heart may be satogun is there, but I am not speaking about that satya. am speaking about Shuddha Sattva. That's why Stityam Satya finally going to take place. Going to show stability of Sattva Guna. You know. And second term is Prasidati. Prasidati meaning Prasannata. Your heart is going to be satisfied fully. This prasannata satisfaction is only possible when you are going to get pure devotion. If bhakti is not there, then you cannot get prasannata, satisfaction. This satisfaction is not ordinary satisfaction. As and when you are going to get some material satisfaction, you are going to, no, not that satisfaction. Stittam satya prasidati. You can get stability of your heart with satagun, suddha sata. And this stability can bring non-stop happiness. Prasidati. Prasidati. You can get prasannata, satisfaction, full satisfaction. You can get. And in this way, by this scientific procedure, actually, you can find evam prasanna manaso. When your heart is totally satisfied, gradually, by this procedure, you are going to attain this stage of satisfaction. Any kind of impediments in the very beginning, I was speaking now, material people can go on speaking about material topics, try to remain indifferent on those topics. Material people can go on speaking about all material topics. You cannot stop them speaking that kind of nonsense. But you have your right to remain indifferent. No, follow. Untouched. And if your target is fixed up, at any condition, you are not going to change your mind. Evam prasanna manaso bhakti, and bhagavad bhakti yogataha. By the power of bhakti yoga, when your mind going to get this kind of stability of satisfaction due to nishtha, then bhagavat tattva vijnanam mukta sangasya jayate. In that case, bhagavat tattva vijnan you can get very easily. You can get bhagavat tattva vijnan very easily in that case. This way, you can avoid all attachment for material things. When you are going to grow attachment for Supreme Lord in Harikatha, every fraction of second, non-stop, in that case, that devotee who is trying sadhak become very satisfied. And he develop rati. Today, if I can get time, I can discuss in details about Ruchi, Bhava, Rati, all in details. Bhagavad, Vishay, Rati. In that case, a heart is not going to be contaminated by any matter. And you are sure that when material conception is there, never you can get satisfaction. Artham anartham bhavayoni anitvam. You know, artham anartham, artha, I mean the enjoying, you know, artha, artha mean you want to get something by the application of which we, artham, artha doesn't mean only money, you are going to get something. So you can use it for your enjoyment, materially. Then you can use it, artha. Artha means after giving so much energy in return, what you expect. That is called artha. Artha doesn't, all the time, doesn't mean money. None mean. You know. So, When your heart is not contaminated with matter, then only then that kind of bhakti yoga is possible. Otherwise, not. Bhav bhakti udai, I am speaking about. Bhav bhakti udai, it can get like sunrise. In that case, Bhagavani, you can bhav bhakti and prem bhakti, yes, they are two brothers, bhav bhakti, prem bhakti. And you can sarup, gun, lila, oisarya, you know, appliances, madhurya, vigyat, all you can feel then, not before that. Not before that. So, you can grow that kind of detachment. Detachment of material things. And it also going to mean, detachment mean attachment to Supreme Lord. Just opposite. Detachment mean is attachment. You are growing detachment mean 100% you are growing attachment to Supreme Lord. If your detachment is dry detachment, be sure you are blind. You cannot get any facility. That your dry detachment can throw you into the ocean of Mayavad. So I am less interested about detachment and attachment. In Gita, Bhagavan speaking, na bhakta mam abhijanati yavan jaschasmi tattataha tato mam tattato gyatva vishati tadanantaram. Bhagavan in Gita, my devotee gradually can know all these things, this gradual procedure. Tattato, what is my tatta? They can understand. This way they can understand all tatta, everything. And this is the gradual procedure through which you can get all facility. Otherwise, if you are going to break rules and regulation, then there is danger in your life. You can remember I was discussing about how to keep in secrecy. Suppose Guru Vaishnava is going to give you kippa. Suppose you are going to get extra facility due to, you know, your bhajan. You are doing bhajan. You are going to get extra facility from Guru Vaishnava. Exclusive kippa. In that case, you should not speak anything. Maybe in dream you can find something. Or you can, in the way of doing Harinam, you can feel something. But you should not speak it to anybody. That's why Narottama Thakur was speaking in Ketan, Prem Bhakti Chandika, Parthana Prem Bhakti. You must read without going through Parthana Prem Bhakti Chandika, nobody can come out successful. Nobody can. Perfect success cannot come. So, as a Gauriya devotee, it is your duty to go through Parthana Prem Bhakti Chandika in details. Actually, our Narottama Thakur speaking, Gopete Sadiva Siddhi. Gopete means very secretly, I can do my bhajan. If there is bhava, rati, prema coming, I cannot allow other people to know. It's secret property. I cannot go here and there in market with an open banner. I am a Raganuga Bhakta, Rupanuga devotee. You see, I am a great monkey. Not there. It's a question of secrecy. The more you get that kind of ecstatic feeling, love is called treasure. Not treasure, secret treasure. Topmost secret treasure. Why you can open your heart in front of common people? Whereas we learn from Mahaprabhu, Bahiranga Dekhi Prabhu Korilen Bhava Sangbharan. Nila Chale Mahaprabhu, I can discuss, then I can show you exact, direct example. Mahaprabhu feeling ecstatic feeling, but still when Mahaprabhu watches the outside people are there, Mahaprabhu somehow check up. Same thing with Prabhupada. Prabhupada speaking Harikatha at the bank of Radhakunda is somehow going to break down. It's an ecstatic feeling coming. But somehow Prabhupada very forcefully tried to check up. Throats, chokta, cannot speak anything, tears going to roll down his cheeks, voice, you know, vibration, you know, sweat coming, all different kind of, you know, body shaking, this kind of, you know, ecstatic feeling coming. These are all secrets. You should not open the secrets in front of others. That's why Jiva Goswami is already in Bhakti Sandarbha, right, giving one warning. I am collecting from different place, you know. So nice argument. Jiva Goswami is going to give warning. Si Guraho Sri Bhagavato Ba Prasada Labdham Sadhano Saddho Gatam Siyo Sarvasso Bhutam Yat Kimopi Rahasyam Tattu Na Kasmaishit Prakashaniyam. If you understand simple Sanskrit, so you can understand. Si Guraho, Si Guraho, Si Bhagavato, Ba Prasada Labdham. I mean, very simple. By the mercy of Gurudev or by the mercy of Bhagavan, anyhow, you are going to get Prasad. Prasad means Kipa. Si Guraho, Sri Bhagavato, Ba Prasada Labdham, Sadhana Sabdugatam Siyam. Sadhana Saddha, you are doing sadhana and going to approach towards your Saddha Vastu, goal. Sadhana Saddha Gatam Siyo, your personal matters. Sarvasya Bhutam, which is very topmost secret in a property. Yat Kimopi Rahasyam, any kind of secrecy about this Kipa, any kind of. Yat Kimopi. Yat kimopi rahasyam, any kind of secrecy regarding this matter, tattu, that should not be expressed in front of others. Tattu, na kasmaischit prakasaniyam. Prakasaniyam. Tattu, na kasmaischit prakasaniyam. It is not to be unveiled in front of outside people. Be careful. Because some Bhagavatam from Srimad Bhagavatam, same thing, what Jiva Goswami Pad giving the instruction, same thing, Jiva Goswami Pad going to give the reference of Bhagavat Sloka. Jiva Goswami Pad going to give Bhagavat Sloka, 8th canto, 17th chapter, 20th sloka. Going to give same example. Naitat parasma akshayam Prishtayapi kathanchano sarvam sampaddate devi devaguiham susangritam sampaddate phaladam bhavati sampaddate phaladam bhavati. Si Guru, by the mercy of, you know, giving example, I already expressed this, and second stroke this from Bhagavatam, giving example, Srimad Bhagavate, Aditir Prati, Vishnu. When Vishnu appeared in front of Aditima, because his bhav, payabrata, milk brata, was satisfied, and going, to give kipa. And Vishnu swayam speaking to mother of demigods. Aditi, Hey Devi, if somebody is going to ask something about the secrecy, don't express. It is my secret kipa to you. Similar way, if some devotee going to get extra kipa, unending kipa from one Guru Vaishnava, that he or she should not express in front of her. Then is danger, you can lose. So, Vishnu going to give warning to Devi, Naitat parasma akshayam prishtayapi kathanchana sarvam sampaddate Devi devaguiham susamritam. Hey Devi, if somebody is going to ask you something about this, anyway, don't try to speak anything, a secret thing. Don't try to express. Because Devaguhyam is Devaguhyam, even demigods cannot understand. So secret. Devaguhyam, Vishasakal, Because this kind of secret things, secret things are there in your life, try to keep it secret. Because if kept secret, then you can get result. Devaguhyo vishay shakal sugupto haili phalaprado hiyate. If it is kept secretly, then and only then you can get result. Otherwise you can miss result. Foolish. You can miss result. Don't speak it to anybody. Devaguhyo is a top secret. Nobody, even demigods, they cannot realize. They cannot understand. If you can keep it secret, then finally you are going to get success in your life. Otherwise, no. So try to understand. If you are going to get this kind of raganubhakti, ruganubhakti, you should not go to market and do advertisement. Then you can lose everything. This material samsara anyway not going to allow you to do bhajan. I went to Nisingapalli to pray for some devotees. And there some old devotees with his old family. He is running to me paying dandavat. I say, Maharaj, I am doing parikram for my person, to beg for kipa, I come here. Then devotee asking me, Maharaj, one slok from Bhagavatam. I am hearing your harikatha, one slok from Bhagavatam. It's very dangerous, I cannot understand. Could you please explain in front of us? And for 2 minutes I explain. He is speaking, why it is written in Bhagavatam, why Krishna is speaking, those family members, everything, those who are friends, and they are all sajanakhadashu. They are like friends, sajan. Sajan means near and dear one, but they are actually enemy, dashu. Going to take away everything, all your vitals of your bhajan. Going to take away everything. Of course, in your family, is everybody devotees? This question is different. It is not applicable here. But actually, it is written in Bhagavatam. I explain that you think your son going to enjoy you and your money. Your father, yes, Maharaj. Your wife going to enjoy you, your money, all your facility, yes, Maharaj. All your daughter, all your friends. Who is friends? In material world, there is no friend. In material world, you can find not genuine friendship. Everybody having some self-interest, if not self-interest openly, but there must be some smell of self-interest. There is one big charitable institution in the market. Maharaj, this X mission, Y mission, going to the charitable institution, they are doing so much thing, But I can show you, 100% I can prove, they are not charitable institution. Only and only Gauriya Mission, Gauriya Mart. Only and only Gauriya Mission is charitable institution because the object of charity here, you are going to get, nobody can take away from you. The object of their charity, medicine, cloth, food for life, idiot. Who are you? Krishna going to give food to everybody. Everybody, Krishna giving. If you calculate how many people going to earn, I am earning something, nothing, but I am getting prasadam. There is no shortage of prasadam. Beasts and birds, they are earning. If you calculate how many countless jivatmas are there, out of them, how many people going to earn? If you count, you can laugh, started laugh. You can start laughing. Oh, so many, a few people going to earn and a whole people going to enjoy. Even one drop of water, Krishna going to arrange for a special bird who is waiting for raindrops, special, phatik jal. Special water. You try to think about the size, what is shape and design and size of this bird. So small bird. And that bird going to cry, fatigue jal, I want to get water, oh Krishna, oh Prabhu. and you try to measure the size of the, you know, mouth of that bird. And you try to understand the Kripa, causeless mercy of Krishna. The size of that leaf, you know, brick is going to, that bird going to open, and Krishna going to give one drop of water into mouth of that bird. Oh, Maharaj, so excellent, eh? Is a man, and you cannot understand. Still, you cannot understand the Kripa of Krishna, Guru Vaishnav. If you know that, you can start crying. If you are not heartless, what kind of causeless mercy of Guru Vaishnav and Bhagavan? You cannot even imagine. Impossible. So you see, this whole world going to utilize you for their own personal ends. That's why I told your body, your money, everything is my property. Because you promise, you tell Maharaj, it is your thing, it is your. You know Maharaj anyway not going to take any funny penny from me. That's why you are going to, if I am going to take everything from you, oh Maharaj taking, where we can stay. I know, very clever you are. Eh? Anyway, so Raghunath Das Goswami Pad speaking in this material world, somehow, if you are going to feel some karma, krodha, somehow you are trying but you are failure, then Raghunath Das Goswami is speaking, you will have to cry, you will have to cry and shout in the name of Guru Varga. Oh Bhaktivinoda Thakur, oh Prabhupada, oh Keshav Goswami Maharaj, oh Bhakti Prabhupada, please save me, save me. You will have to cry. Oh Rup Sanatan, I am going to, you know. Asa chesta kasto pradob bikato pasali viriho prakamam kamadi prakato pathopati vatikarai gale vadya hanni ahamiti bakavit batpapogani kuru tvam phutkaram navati sa yatha tvam manaito. It's very complicated, huh? You have to remember. Asa chesta kasto pradobikato pasali viriyo prakamam kamadi prakata pathapati vyatikarai. Anyway, try to understand. Gale vadhya hanni ahamiti bakavit bhattapagane kuru tvam phutkaran avati sa yatha tvam mana ito. You try to cry. When you are going to be defeated, your tremendous karma, krodha are going to put you in trouble. You cannot do bhajan anymore. Dig danger in front of you. In front of you, you have to call in the name of the messengers of Krishna. Bakari. He killed Bakasur, na? That's why Raghunath says, Tumi Bakari Krishner, Bhakti Marges, Rakhak Saru. Those who all are the protector. Sangrakkhanaiko Acharyo. Siddha Samipat Bhakti Sangrakkhanaiko Acharyo. You know, Baladev Vidyavasan, Vishwanath Chakravarti, Rupa Goswami Pad, who not? They are Jiva Goswami, they are Bhakti Rakshanaiko Acharyo. Now, you can get this kind of thing. At present you can get. Everybody like to break the interest of Sampradaya. Oh, they're useless. I need my personal Pratishtha. Who is Gauriyamad? Who is useless? I am all. I am Demo. Hiranyakashipu. This is our bhakti. You know. But Raghunath Das Goswami is speaking, all those messengers of this Krishna Bakari, they are the protector of this bhakti mark. In the way of a devotional mark, you can find Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Jiva Goswami, Keshav Goswami, the protector. How strongly Keshav Goswami Maharaj used to protest. How if there is a Siddhanta Virodhi, there is any sort of wrong, rasavas, anything, then Keshav Goswami like lion. Now everybody like to prove we are Param Vaishnava, absolute Vaishnava. So we are not going to speak. This is their weakness. This is not their Vaishnavism. The only duty of an acharya is to give full protection to Siddhanta Bani or the treasure of Apasampada. Not that you can stand and look. Oh, let them do. I am Vaishnava, I cannot speak. Foolish number one. This way, you will have to be very careful so that no annavilas, no different kind of thoughts, I mean conception, demand, desire can come and to contaminate your heart. If you are not going to protect yourself, then be sure you can go on hearing Harikatha for infinite, because you are not hearing with full attention, not with full sincerity. Who can protect you? That's why I told yesterday, Bahu janmo kare jodi shavan kirtan, tabu to na pai Krishna pade premdhan. If for life after life they are going to do shravan, kirtan, everything, still be sure they are not going to get Krishna prem because their bhajan is defective. They never try to rectify themselves. Somebody I know, they whenever I speak, Maharaj, I am trying. Maharaj, I am trying. You are trying. If you are trying sincerely, why you are not successful? All the time you are failure. Whenever I say, Maharaj, at least I am trying. Why you are trying? What kind of trying? You know? It's false, you know? If you are at all trying, then divine help you can get. You can come out successful. You cannot speak. This is no, you know, argument I can hear. Maharaj, I am trying. You are trying. What kind of trying? Repeatedly you are failure. Whenever I speak, Maharaj, at least I am trying. Why you are trying? You are not in less interest to understand that pure tattva vigyan, everything. When you are going to do Savan Kirtan perfectly, then be sure it is your Sarup Lakhan. When continuously Namagane Sadaruchi is Savan Kirtan at the Kriya, it becomes Sarup Lakhan. It is expressed. And Tatasarakshan, nobody can understand. Those who are very expert, they can understand. Tatasya lakshane upajaya prema. Prema can develop inside. Nobody can. In Gita also, Bhagavan, you can throw Gita. I know you are so foolish, you are going to throw Gita. Hey, Maharaj, it is external, you know, it is so preliminary. Hey, Maharaj, if you are going to avoid Gita in never, in infinity period, you cannot get stability. You cannot come out successful in your Raganyuga, Rupanyuga, foolish number one. In Gita, Bhagavan giving warning. You can remember, in Gita, Bhagavan going to give, you know, going to give, you know, a warning. What is, many times before I told, Uddharet Atmana Atmanam, Natman, Natmanam Avasadayet. You can remember, you forget, I know. Uddharet Atmana Atmanam, Na atmanam avasadayat. Atmaibo hi atmano bandhu, ratmaibo ripuratmanaha. Gita 6, chapter 6, 5 slok. Uddharet atmana atmanam. Try to help yourself. In English also in small boyhood we read, God helps them, those who help themselves. In one sense, is it okay? You know? It's early to bed and early to rise, make a man wise. They are English people speaking, but still, and they are speaking rightly. Early to bed and early to rise, make a man. That doesn't mean if I cannot go to bed early, I cannot become wise. That's not there. It is for foolish people, outside people. But it is also applicable for us, those who are trying bhajan. Maharaj. Yeah, this Maharaj going to bed, you know, night time, 11 o'clock, so he cannot, not there. But I try to understand the meaning. Early to bed and early to wife, for children, for everybody, applicable. Make him a man wise. You know, early rise when, if you are going to rise early, rise before sunrise, then you can at all do bhajan. If you are not habituated to, you know, get up early in the morning, then no question of any bhajan. Guru Padmani used to say, Maharaj, Baba, simply they cannot get early in the morning. What I can do with them? Eh? Only this thing they cannot do, and they are going to start Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan. Foolish idiot. So udharet atmana atmanam na atmanam avasade. You try to help yourself and don't try to cheat yourself. Don't try to make yourself fed up. Udharet atmanatmanam na atmanam avasade. Don't make that your jivatma fed up. Don't make. Because that atma is your friend when acting favorably. That atma, jivatma, going to act as a friend. Atmaibo hi atmana bandhu. You know, this atma is your friend when you are going to do favorably. That atma is just foe, ripuratmanaha, foe, enemy, when you are doing wrongly. So we have nothing to do. That's why Krishna told na in Gita, repeatedly I speak, you can remember. Repeatedly you can remember. Na adasya kasya chit papam, na chaiva sukritim vibhum, agyanena avritam jnanam, teno muhyanti yantava. I told. You cannot remember. So this way, you are going to get detailed information about how to protect yourself in bhajan. Now I like to step into our discussion from Raya Ramananda Sangadi. This is also a part of Raya Ramananda Sangadi actually. I was discussing about so many things, you know, from, you can remember, from Santaras, I was giving explanation, Adhikrita Das, Brahma, Sankara, Adhikrita Das, so many things, Uddhav, Daruk, and I was speaking. But today, Shakharas, before understanding Shakharas, Santaras after Dasharas already, Santaras previous day. And yesterday I discussed about Dasharas, still previous day I was discussing about Santaras. Yesterday I was discussing about Dasharas, now Shakharas. But before discussing about Shakharas, we should have a clear conception about Ruchi, Nishtha, Prem, everything. Or not that, and basically we should know it very clear. If there is no basic conception about this, then we are total failure. You cannot come out successful. So what do you mean Ruchi? I already touched yesterday, not I couldn't go in detail. Ruchi mean actually test. Ruchi mean test. When you are going to grow jaundice disease, then you are not going to get any test of sugar and canary, nothing. Ruchi, you know, you are not getting any test. Also, I heard those who are growing corona, they are also not getting any test of any. What they are taking, there is no smell or no test. I mean, really so? Well, yes, this is one symptom. They are not going to get any test and, you know, and no smell of what they are taking. It's very dangerous. Okay. But this Ruchi meant test. When a strong test, you know, when you are going to get a strong test of the, all the glories of Supreme Lord, you are getting, and this week, and this kind of testing going to take such a form that it becomes much more agreeable than talks on mundane topics. Now you are less interested that what Mahaprabhu already told to Raghunath Das Gosai, try to remember. Our discussion should be big area, through a big area, so that I can show you example. Mahaprabhu already told to Raghunath Das Gosai as a final advice, you know, Grammo kata na koibe, Grammo bata na bolibe, Grammo kata na sunibe, bhalo na kaibe ar bhalo na poribe. Today also I started with it. Material people can go on talking about material things, what it concerns to you. You should remain indifferent to them. So, this same thing, Mahaprabhu speaking, je gammo katha na koibe. Don't try to speak anything material and don't try to hear anything material. Gammo katha na koibe, gammo katha na bolibe, gammo katha na sunibe, balo na kaibe ar balo. Don't try to become busy. to get nice, you know, bhoga, prasad, is very offensive, very bad. Don't try to wear good. You're wearing, because you're now Vaishnava, Vaishnavi. If you are going to wear a, you know, very excellent, you know, majestic arrangement, your cosmetics and, you know, dress, then surely you are not getting the taste of bhakti. Then why you are going to waste your time? By cosmetics, you know, costly cosmetics and this, that, you know, and nice dress. Oh, Maharaj, you are niskinchan. Your property is my property, not your property. So you are skinchan. Eh? Try to understand. So this kind of, and any kind of material talkings, you are going to lose your test. No. Grammukutana kaibe, grammukutana sunibe, balona kaibe, balona boribe. Don't try to wear good, don't try to track good things. And always try to do Harinam Sankirtan. Bairagi kare sada nam sankirtan, mangiya khaiya kare udar bharan. Jagadananda Pandit speaking, those who are already in renounce order, growing detachment for them, it is prescribed, they should not arrange money, position, everything. You know, what they can do? Bairagi kare sada nam sankirtan. Mahat Mahaprabhu speaking, Parshad also speaking the same. Jagadananda Pandit Premvivarta speaking, that is the duty of a Bairagi, those who are already in renounce order or in, you know, growing detachment, for them to sing the glories of Krishna all the time. Sometime in Mala, sometime in Harikatha, sometime in Kirtan. Different. Bairagi kare sada nam sankirtan. Sada mane a Bairagi, those who are developing Vairagya, they are always, their symptom is that they are always going to sing about the glories of Supreme Lord, hearing Sukhina, Vairagi kare karishada, nam sankirtan, mangiya khaiya kare udarbharan. Always going to beg, mother, give me some rice, wheat, or, you know, barley, anything. They are begging. You know, sagu, what I need, I can beg from you, whatever I need. Okay. Anyway, this way actually, whenever I need, not that I can get 20 kg sago and make it stock in my, so that there is a, while you are starting corona, so who can feed me? Maharaj, you come and check me. I am not going to stock rice, wheat, nothing. Nothing. I am getting everything by mercy of Supreme Lord. So don't always try to believe. So this way actually, you are going to feel detested when you are going to hear any material thing. You are less interested to hear material thing. Let's go. You are going to lose. This ruchi or test for the singing, you know, namagani sadaruchi, test for the singing of the glories of Lord, can be divided into two parts, in two folds. One, to pay equal attention to all aspects of bhakti. You are not going to pay special attention to any special mode of bhakti. This can be done. And one is, somebody going to pay special attention to one of such, you know, nine folds of bhakti. To feel agreeably affected for the various, you know, modes of bhakti, keeping in view the more important. You are giving more importance to this. Suppose you like to hear Harikatha, so you are going to speak Harikatha. Yeah. And the less important aspects for other bhakti, other type of bhakti. So ruchi, you understand. After ruchi, atha asakti. Asakti means attachment. Though perfect translation is not possible, Premadi, but I am trying by the mercy of previous Guru Bhargava. You know, I am collecting different, you know, a term. Oh, Maharaj, how to use it? If I speak, they can misunderstand me. They cannot, you know. So, asakti means attachment. When the taste for services of Supreme Lord develops into full form, I mean full grown maturity, and the Lord alone becomes the sole object of your life. Bhagavan is all. You are no second object. So the Lord alone becomes the sole object of your life. Mat pranathasu swayavana paraha. Mahaprabhu speaking. Mat pranathasu swayavana paraha in Sikh custom. In that case, then such an intensity of spiritual practice by a devotee, it creates a glue like adhesive. The attachment is like adhesive, very strong adhesive. Asakti. You know, anyway, anyhow, any circumstances, you are not going to change your mood. In no way he is going to change. So, in that case, that we shielding tree, Icha, Kalpalata, Kripar, or Bhakti, in the form of loving services of Supreme Lord, growing day by day. It's asakti. And when asakti coming inside your heart, what will happen? What? Because you should know. Because you will have to act as a doctor, Ayurvedic, a physician. So you have to know all different, you know. Not that Guru Bhargava can stay. They can go away from this material world. Also you will have to take a responsibility, you know. If there is no, if nobody interested to take the post of a real preacher, Nishkinjan Bhakta, then who can do it? Or cheater can come and cheat the whole world. So you should know what all are the symptoms. This asakti cleans the heart, very, you know, the heart of a devotee, and makes it so transparent that the Lord's reflection appears therein. In such a way, as if the Lord has appeared before the devotee in person. You can feel the Supreme Lord is standing in front of you. When asakti is there, sometimes you here is Bhagavan. Yeah, you can find. Sometimes in dream, here, there. This way, this practice is very good. The devotee in the early stage of spirituals, sadhaka, as for example, a devotee in the early stage of spiritual practice, purposely turns his mind towards the Supreme Person, but as soon as he is going to get asakti, then you can feel spontaneous, automatic attraction. Spontaneously, and you know, continuous and spontaneous attraction. The stage of asakti can give you this kind of facility. Any kind of problem can come in your life, not going to put you in trouble, or maybe putting you going to put you in trouble, it's not a matter for you, because you are not going to lose your bhajan anyway. So much stability, so much asakti is called asakti. You can go on thinking about Supreme Lord. Attachment between Bhakta and Bhagavan is so strong that nobody can break this relationship. It's not possible. Nobody can break this. So sweetness of the relation. Sure, sweetness. Sweetness of the relation. Because all worldly talkings and worldly matters, affairs, become a bonding for bonded soul. More and more bondage. And for this kind of devotees who is going to asakti, is going to ruchi, asakti, bhava, they are going to think it useless. You can remember Prabhupada Prabhupada Saraswati Vaspulna, Kaivalla narakayate tidasa piro. You can remember the sloka I explained before. Kaivalla narakayate tidasa pura akasa paspayate. Duddantendriya kala sarva patali prathatu dangstayate. Vidhi mahendadnischa kitayate. Vishyampurna sukhayate. Yat koruna kataksha vaivabatam. Tam gauro mevastamam. You can remember, I explained before. If time demands, I can explain more. Kaivallana, kaivalla, this kind of salvation, kaivalla mukti, useless. It's like hell. I don't like to speak about this kaivalla. Kaivallana rakayate, tidasa pura akasa spayate. Or sarga, heaven, hell, you know, seven, heaven. Tidasa pura akasa, this material appearance here in material world. And heaven, and all useless. Tidasa pur akasapus payate. It's useless thing. He can think it is useless. Why should I think? No. Sargo matto patal. No. Sargo matto patal. Useless. Tidasa pur akasapus payate. Duddantendriyo kalo sarpapatali pratkato dung strayate. All your sense organs going to put you in trouble, but now the sense organ acting like a snake, which is without any teeth, poison teeth. When the poison teeth of a snake is, you know, eradicated, then the snake, you can play with the snake. You can sleep with the snake. No problem. Now the poison is not there. You can play. Even a boy can play. Try to understand. Then all your sense organs can act like a snake without poisonous teeth. All problem over? Tidasa pura kasavus duddan tendriyo kalo sarpapatali patkatadam stayate vidhi mahendadishya kitayate. Mahendra mani Indra, his post, the king of heaven, become very useless for you, and the post of Brahma, useless for you. It's become useless for you. Oh, useless. Mahendadishya kitayate. Vidhi mahenda. Vidhi mean Brahma. Vidhi mahendadishya kitayate. And you can find the whole world is full of bliss. Vishyampurna sukhayate. Vishyampurna sukhayate. The world is full of, you know, love. You know. Because one genuine sadhu, for him, the whole world is his family member. Vishyampurna sukhayate, a genuine sadhu think it matters little whether he is from Brazil, he is from England, he is from Costa Rica, he is from America, he is from Italy, German, no matters. It matters little. He thinks it is my whole one family. So connected, so lovefully connected. This is the thing. It is the mood of a, You know, those material people using this word as cosmopolitan, but I cannot use this word. This is not matching word. You know, this is not matching word. You cannot understand the heart of a pure devotee. How soft their heart, how loveful their heart. You know, you cannot feel. So, Vishyampurna sukhayate, the whole world is full of bliss. Oh, what is the problem? Nothing. When you are going to get the full kripa of Nityananda Prabhu, Gauranga Prabhu, I mean the kripa of Radha Govinda Prabhu, Radha Govinda Ji, then this kind of situation can come in your life, which is inexplicable. I cannot speak so much philosophy to make you understand, not possible. Any amount of philosophy, any amount of understanding is not enough to give direct realization, what you mean to, what I mean to say. So this is the condition. So now actually after ruchi, you understand this asakti, after this bhava. What do you mean by bhava? What do you mean by bhava? What do you mean by bhava? Bhava is actually, when the above explained asakti, attachment, along with ruchi, or in other sense I would say, spontaneous test you are getting, in that case, it can soften your heart, it can soften your heart, mind, and ego can come down to a zero level. You can feel Trinadapi. Yesterday I was speaking, no? Dante Tinakam Nidhayo. I am speaking, no? And also, in that case, your false ego can come down to zero level. Danto tinakam nidhayo padayor nipatto. I can discuss tomorrow. No time today. You know, this humbleness can come. So false ego can go to sub-zero level. Zero level it can come in sub-zero level. Because Raghunath Das Gosai, his Vairagya, Krishnadas Kaviragya, sub-zero level. Not zero level. And all reasoning faculties reach a point of melting. I mean all conditions, situation inside, making a condition so that you are going to melt down, your heart going to melt down, is called Baba. This Baba is the innate nature of the self. You know, self-same potency. It is due to Sarva Shakti Kipa. Baba can come, this gradually can come by the mercy of Sarupa Shakti or internal potency, Antaranga Shakti. You can develop. And if this kind of situation going to touch your heart, this kind of situation, then immediately it can give rise, you know, this kind of situation, all-powerful Supreme Lord, about all-powerful Supreme Lord, in that case, you know, and immediately you have this kind of sunrise, I already told, Prema Surya, the sun of Prema going to rise. Now the eastern zone is reddish in color. After some time, you can find golden, molten gold. After that, you can find reddish sun god going to rise. The situation. When a devotee maintains to, you know, no, sorry. When a devotee attains this kind of stage of Baba Bhakti, Baba Rati, Baba Bhakti, Baba Rati, the following 9 kind of symptoms can be seen inside him, automatically can develop. That symptom I was bound to speak 2 days ago. You can remember, Khantir, you see, not a matter of joke. You are going to get scientific explanation of all that, nobody can make fool of you. Khantir abhyartha karattam viraktir manasunnata asabandhu samatkancha namagani sadaruchi Asaktista gunakshani pitistat vasadistale ittadayo anubhavaha suryato bhavan kureyane. Those who are going to get bhava, surely they are going to get this kind of facility. This kind of sophisticated condition of heart you can feel. That 9 kinds of condition I am going to explain. I already explained before, but now I am going to touch, because otherwise you cannot understand what Rai Ramanandu wanted to speak and what Mahaprabhu wanted to explain. Mahaprabhu wanted to explain this, you know, very clearly about all these things. When a Baba Bhakti coming, going to melt your heart, you are going to Prem Surya, Prem Sango, you know, Prem Surya going to rise, in that case, he cannot bear even wastage of 1 fraction of second of time. Constantly he want to be engaged, he or she want to be engaged in this kind of bhajan. I have seen in my life such devotees, I am very lucky. Continuously those who are doing bhajan. Such matajis, they leave their body now, not. We should take dust particle from their lotus feet all the time. so much, you know, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, they're getting the highest stage. It's, you know, inconceivable. So this kind of condition can create, you are not going to bear even a one fraction of second waste of time, you cannot bear. Then second is that there is mental khyantir abhyarthakalatam viraktir manasundata. You are going to develop detachment, I mean the mental quantum of such a devotee remains perfectly calm and quiet and composed even if there be some or certain causes of extreme excitement. In very easy word, I like to say, if there is any question of at all excitement, blood coming from your hand, you are excitement. This was there, you know, that's why it's happening. Excitement should not be there. Excitement, by, if you feel excitement, you can lose your bhajan. So, mental stability in such a condition, calm and quiet. No chanchal bhav. And even there is a question of excitement coming, but still, it's calm and quiet. So, shantir abhyarthakalattam viraktir manasunyata, virakti. He developed natural detachment from worldly objects. No attachment for anything. Anything is not at anything. You can try a Vaishnava. You cannot put them in danger. They have no attraction for anything. They are living for you all. No reason for why they are living. They are living for you all. Why Prabhupada is going to live? Why Bhakti going to live? They are going to give some, you know, going to help us in our bhajan. This kind of detachment, viraktir manasunyata. Manasunyata means, even there is so much nice qualities, noble qualities. Maybe he is that Vaishnava. He is having nice noble qualities. But still, he is not going to pay any attention. He is not going to think, I have nothing. Hailyo sarvagune guni mahasaya. Bhakti Mataji speaking. Hailyo sarvagune guni mahasaya. Patishtasa taji karo amani hidaya. Though there is so much noble qualities inside you, I know you are a poet, you can write poetry, but you foolish, you will have to start, you know, transcendental poetry. Foolish you are, material philosopher. Foolish, you know. He is, you know, this way, he is not going to, he has no estimation about his own, you know, quality. So a noble quality, what? I have nothing, you know, I am useless. Yes, sir. And always going to give honor to others. Always going to give honor to others. He has a firm faith in the realization of God in this way of life and meeting with His beloved Lord. This way, all the time. Amani manat. If Tinadapi is not going to touch my heart, I cannot speak Harikatha. If I think I can bless you all the time, then I am not going to understand. I cannot speak that way. Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, writing one letter to a devotee whose age is almost same or maybe a little bit higher. Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. He is writing in letter, and after reading letter, that devotee started crying. Maharaj, Gurudev writing this way letter to me, how I can live? Oh my God, he starts crying. So much humbleness. So, those who are pure Vaishnava, they are not going to speak that way. I can bless you. They are speaking, oh mother, mama, you can bless me. You can bless me, you all can bless me, so that I can do bhajan. This is their mood. They never think I can bless you. You know, how I can bless? I have no bhajan, nothing. How I can bless you? I can pray to Supreme Lord for you. You know, Follow. This kind of, you know, Trinadapi bhav should be there. Because otherwise you cannot do perfect bhajan. All the time, try to kick out all your vanity or false ego, anatta, try to kick it out after hearing Harikatha. Try to, come on, there is no time, life is very short. We are playing. Life is going and we are playing. Life is going, we are playing. This kind of attachment. This way, no? All the time he liked to sing. Constantly singing the glories, kirtan. You know? All the time, kirtan. Not that you will have to practice kirtan, you can play, you can buy one ear organ and start kirtan. Sa re ga. What? Foolish. Wasting time. Do kirtan. If there is no sweetness of your voice, still Krishna can accept. Krishna is less interested about your sweet voice. Sridhar Goswami Maharaj sing, Sri Rupa Manjiro Pado. Jargam in Baba singing, he must sing this song. He must sing. So you are paying attention to external things. You know, sometime by the mercy of Bhagavan, they are getting sweet voice. Sometime somebody not going to get sweet voice. What it concerns to Supreme Lord? Is one to one to get bhakti. I am interested to know your bhakti. What is it? The way you are singing is good. You can sing. Maybe you cannot pronounce properly. Maharaj, I cannot recite Gita like you, foolish. You cannot do, you can try. If you cannot try, still you try again and again. Because Mahaprabhu is interested about your bhava, heart. You can remember the South Indian tour. When Mahaprabhu went to Ranganatham, one so-called devotee, Brahman, he was reciting Gita daily. He cannot pronounce, he is uneducated, almost uneducated. Hey, what is he doing? And everybody laughing. Hey, cannot pronounce. But Mahaprabhu was very interested. Mahaprabhu was very happy. One day Mahaprabhu was saying, you know, if you never mind, you are reciting Gita. Why you are reciting Gita? Everybody laughing at you. But yeah, Prabhu, I know everybody laughing because I cannot pronounce properly. You know. But still you are doing. But why? Because I am reading Gita, reciting Gita by the order of my Guruji. Though I am not educated fully, I cannot pronounce properly. Let them laugh. I am reading, reciting Gita by the instruction of the order of my Guruji. And what you feel? Mahaprabhu saying, what you feel? So that you can stop reading Gita? But Maharaj, when I am reading Gita, so long as I am reciting Gita, I can clearly see there is a chariot in which Krishna going to get advice Gita and Arjuna bow down unto lotus feet, leaving all bow and arrow, everything's, you know, shrugging head, you know, bending head, you know, swadhimam tam prapanyam. So long as I am reciting Gita, believe me, I am going to see the constant picture, very sweet picture. And Krishna going to in chariot, Krishna going to keep advice, Arjuna going to listen. And really so, Mahaprabhu. Oh no, your reading Gita is perfect, 100%. You can read this way, because Bhavagrahi Janardana going to take your heart. Guru Vaishnava already want to take the test of your heart. They are less interested about the material things. Follow what I say. Bhavagrahi Janardana. Somebody speaking, they don't know Sanskrit. Bishnayo. Somebody speaking. Bishnayo speaking. Somebody speaking. You know. At this way. But still, Bhagavan never mind. Pronunciation wrong, kirtan wrong, they cannot speak. But still, Bhagavan going to bless you. You are from outside, you know, country. Don't think that you are from outside country. If you feel this way, you can become, you know, weak. Don't think. You can think, no, I am from here. Yes, I think you are from here. Otherwise, you cannot get, you know, power. Always try to think this way. Try and try again. Bhagavan is not blind. Bhagavan is so kind, so kind, so kind, Guru Vaishnava. If you try, you cannot see you are blind, Bhagavan standing backside. You are reciting wrongly, you are spelling wrongly, but Bhagavan laughing. Let him do. Like a small boy, when growing boy, very small boy, very infant stage, cannot speak father, mother, cannot speak properly. But when speaking, somehow, mother become very happy, father become very happy. Somehow, you know, he is going to speak papa, papa, mama, mama, this way. And in Bhagavatam, it is written, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Kalaksharanam anurakta dhiya. Those material people, they are feeling attachment for their small boy, just you know, taken birth and grown up little bit, after speaking, papa, papa, mama, they are very happy. And to hear how sweetly my boy is speaking. Then, after hearing, going to take in lap and kissing repeatedly. Oh, so nice. But you will have to kiss Krishna. You will have to learn. Vatsala rasa. You will have to grow. I can speak tomorrow. What Prabhupada is speaking. So if you are going to grow, you know, Shakha rasa, you will have to understand all these things. Otherwise, all useless for you. You cannot, you know, Kalaksharanam anurakta dhiya. When a small boy, small baby is speaking nicely, that the man, I mean the father, feeling very enjoyment, so nicely speaking, fa 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 fa. But it's all maya, maya, maya. All maya, be careful. Maya. Try to hear Harikatha nicely and try to digest. If you cannot digest, no assimilation is there, then indigestion, you will have to suffer from indigestion. So constantly, he likes to sing the name, glory of Supreme Lord. His attachment for singing the glories of the Lord remains steady. Namagane sadaruchi. Not that this situation he cannot sing. This situation is not, you know, not that. He passionately loves Vrindavan, the eternal realm of Supreme Lord. I like to stay there. Nābhāvāne sadāruchi, vane asaktistat gunākṣane vasatistat. Vasatistat, you know, asaktistat gunākṣane pitistat vasatistare. Where Krishna living, I mean dham, is automatic attraction. If physically not possible, you will have to live in Vrindavan mentally. Be careful. Don't try to live in Italy. Don't try to live in German. Don't try to live in Austria. You will have to stay in Vrindavan, Navadvip Dham. Mentally, continuously, you will have to stay here if you want to get success. There are so many points I like to discuss regarding those points. More elaborate way, because Vishwanath Chakravarti was discussing in Madhurya Kadambini all in details about this, you know, things. So more details way. This Baba is also called Rati. I can discuss one or two. Today time cannot permit. When this kind of Baba Bhakti coming, it's just like I told you, you know, my Guru Maharaj give me one advice. My son, don't be busy with preaching. Try to do bhajan fast. If your bhajan is perfect, you need not go to foreign countries. All people can come to you, can hear you. Guru Padma used to say, let them do, let them run. nor name, name, fame, position, Rani, money. You need not do it. Guru Maharaj used to give one example. My son, in a garden, if there is one nice flower garden, so nice, you know, smell of flowers, fragrance, sweet smell coming. And those bees, they automatically get attracted. Nobody going to send them letter of invitation. Nobody going to speak them, hello, bolo, come. They're not speaking. But they're automatically coming. Because this kind of situation is created there. Those, this nice garden, there is nice, nice flowers, lotus, you know, rose, jasmine, nice, nice flowers. Automatically, those bees, they are filling it nursery, you know. It is a stable pressure. They are coming. Nobody can stop them. They are coming in search of nectar. Guru Padmami used to give me this example. My son, if you are going to do bhajan perfectly, if you love everybody, if you love Supreme Lord, automatically, it's an automatic factor. Preaching can be done automatically by you. Nobody can stop your preaching automatically. It's an automatic factor. So you'll have to follow some term condition. You'll have to. So Vishwanath Chakravarti also going to give same example. The fragrance, the smell of those flowers of Baba Bhakti, of a devotee, forcefully attracts Sri Krishna, the Lord, like a bee. Krishna is like a bee. You know, you can remember. You know, Sri Krishna, in Rasamriti Sindhu, I can discuss tomorrow, in Rasamriti Sindhu, you know, Rupa Goswami is saying, bhakti, definition of bhakti. And ultimately writing, Sri Krishna Karsani Chosa. Sri Krishna Karsani Chosa, ultimately speaking. So different kind of, you know, bhajan, different devotees doing. If at all they are not going to cheat Supreme Lord, they are, you know, step by step they are entering. And by the mercy of Supreme Lord, they are entering into the area of Baba. Is also Rati and Prema, they are automatically going to get. Then Krishna, the bee, black bee, Radharani speaking, Brahma Gita, black bee. Radharani is going to drive, hey, go away, foolish, you know, you're a cheater, going to make fool of me. And I know, you are the messenger of that black bee. I don't like to hear anything from you. Go away. You know, this way Radharani, like mad speaking. Brahma Gita is black bees. Krishna is a, you know, topmost black bees going to be attracted by your bhakti. By your Baba Bhakti. Krishna can forcefully, it can attract Krishna. Krishna can come. Irrespective of your caste and kids and land, it no matter, Maharaj. Even, you know, from Ramayana you can know that Ramchandra was bound to meet Guhak Chandal. Ramchandra was bound to meet Savari, Billibai, is a daughter of a tribal daughter. You know, tribal daughter. Oh my God. Tribal god, very low caste. But I must pay dandavat unto the lotus feet of those devotees like Lakshahira, this way I will have to pay dandavat because they are successful. I am not successful. Where is bhakti inside me? I should think this way. Always humble mode. This way you can see that Guhak Chandal, low caste. Chandal mean, you know Chandal? In Indian society, those who are going to dead body, those going to give treatment to, final treatment to dead body by fire, is called Chandal. Chanda means low caste, low, so low caste. You know, but if the Chandal is going to get the kippa of Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan, I can give the example like Veda, that Veda, by the mercy of Naraji Maharaj, going to get the kippa of Naraji, now is Vaishnava. Now I cannot speak that Veda is useless. That hunter is useless. Hunter is Vaishnava. Hunter is now Vaishnava, great Vaishnava. No, I like to get dust particle from his lotus feet. He is great Vaishnava now. I should not speak that he is hunter. I should not speak that way. I should not speak that Lakha Hira is frost. I should take dust particle from her lotus feet. This should be moved. I can take dust particle from the lotus feet of Savari Ma. His mother, Savari, maybe from low caste. So what? Ramchandra was very much attracted by the bhakti of Savari. Savari waiting for a long time to get the darshan of Ramchandra, Paratpara Vilesha. Also, you can name a Guhok Chandal. Somehow, Ramchandra was bound to accept seva from Guhok Chandal. Guhok Chandal coming with boat and Ramchandra giving in seva, so that Ramchandra, like a human being, Sita, Ram, Lakshman, they can cross the river and go that side of the river, helping. So, Bhagavan is so merciful, in infinity period, if you go on thinking, you cannot come with conclusion. I can give another example. With this, I will have to stop because I have so many seva, more seva, other seva. So you are here, you see, when Ramchandra going to make Shetu Bandhan, Rameswaram, in South India, at the bank of, you know, sea, you know, Bharat Mahasagar, Indian Ocean, Ramchandra wanted to make bridge to reach Lanka. And Hanumanji Maharaj, Sugrib, Nal, everybody helping. Jai Sri Ram! Writing Ram on the stone and in the throw. Hanumanji Maharaj, Acharya, going to throw stone. After writing Ramnam, the stone is floating. You cannot believe. Maharaj, science and technology cannot believe it. I'll leave your science and technology. Foolish number one. Still today you can find internet. You can see, go deep into the water of Indian Ocean. You can find when Ramchandra coming back from Lanka by the request of Varundev, Samudra Devata, were bound to break the, you know, bridge. Varundev speaking, Prabhu, you are going, why you are binding me, Prabhu, make me free. Then after that, reaching the shore, Ramchandra going to, you know, break the bridge with one arrow. And that bridge you can find clearly. Clearly, from Sri Lanka up to Rameswaram, you can find down all stones there inside water. You can go and check up. It is not false. Foolish. You know. This way, Ramchandra, you know, this way going to help. And all Hanumanji Maharaj, Nal, Sugrib, you know, they are going to help making the bridge. By the mercy of Krishna, by the mercy of Ramnam, they are successful to make the bridge. But in the meanwhile, one very small creature, his name is Squirrel, Katbirali, Squirrel. Sometimes he forget. I'm not speaking all the time, you know. Squirrel. That squirrel want to do seva for that. In Setu Bandhan, a squirrel going to water and making body, you know, wet, and coming to shore, taking some sand, you know, rolling down on ground, on sand, getting some sand, you know, with the body, and going to sea, and pushing, you know, throwing into sea. Ramchandra watching it, oh, so nice seva mood, Maharaj. So nice seva mood. Everybody going to, hey, what you are doing, foolish? Ramchandra going to give great value. Oh, so dear, so nice seva you are doing. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on in my hand. Then Ramchandra going to take the squirrel and hand, going to, going to roll his hand, finger on the body to show a loveful mood. Oh, so nice you are doing seva. From then, you can find the fingerprint, three fingerprints on the backside of a squirrel. This kind of love is there with Supreme Lord. Nobody can stop me from going unto lotus feet of Supreme Lord. This should be my resolution in my life. This should be my resolution in my life. Don't try to bake your energy. Don't try to bake your energy. Don't try to bake your energy. With full enthusiasm, try to jump into the field of rasa, prema. Madhuguna suti matre namai sarva guhasai manogati ravichinna yatha gangamba soambudhau lakshanam bhakti yogasya nirgunasya udahritam nirgunasya hi udahritam ahitukya pratiyata ja bhakti purushottami madhuguna suti matre namai sarva guhasai manogati ravichinna yatha gangamba soambudhau lakshanam bhakti yogasya nirgunasya hi udahritam ahituki apratihata ja bhakti hi purushottami vancha kalpadurvasike basindu bhavacha patitanam pavanibho vaishnavibhyo namo.